Hey, what's up everyone? Monado Max here, and today we're going to be talking about Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, something everyone loves to speculate about. I feel like everywhere you look, you see people speculate Smash Bros. So for this video, we're going to be talking about Smash Bros. Exclusively. We did just drop a Nintendo E3 predictions video, which you can go watch in the description below, which we have one of our same guests for this video. And this is our E3 predictions of Smash Bros, in case anybody was wondering. So I'm going to introduce my guest. I have Itachi Cosplays.
Hey everyone, hope you guys are doing well.
We have, actually from the Four Swords podcast, we have Miles Per Hour.
Hello there, it's Miles Per Hour, and all aboard the hype train.
Yes, the hype train legit is so close. Like, E3 is literally so close. I'm starting to get really pumped, guys. I really am starting to get pumped.
Yeah, absolutely tantalizing.
Mm-hmm. So I'm going to start off with some disappointing news of my predictions. I see a lot of people thinking we're going to get we're just going to get the rest of the Fighters Pass revealed at this E3. That in a good world, that would be awesome. But I don't see Nintendo doing that since they only have two characters left to promote. Because they can do a whole Smash Bros. Event to reveal this final character. This is like a whole nother marketing tool they could use. If we had three characters left, I would think two characters would be very likely. But since we are at the final two characters, I'm thinking we're only getting one reveal, and it's actually going to be the opening of E3, most likely. So, I have three characters that I think this could be. I'm going to start out with one that we know, according to leaks, this seems to be 100% happening, and that is Ryu Hayabusa. I don't know if this would be our E3 reveal, although it's a big character for some people, and I wouldn't be surprised if this was our E3 reveal, if they wanted to save the final reveal as a mega reveal. I don't know. But the Ryu being in Smash makes the most sense if you look at the history with Nintendo and Koei Tecmo games. Oh, wait, no, that's not Koei Tecmo. That's the other Team Ninja, right?
Wait, is it Koei Tecmo? Yeah, but Koei Tecmo's right too. They're like same people.
Oh, okay. Yeah. All right. Well, the history there with Nintendo has been very strong. Nintendo has hired them to develop a lot of Nintendo games. Like, they hired them to develop the Ultimate Alliance 3 game. They hired them for, obviously, the Hyrule Warriors games, Fire Emblem Warriors. They even did some work for Fire Emblem Three Houses. So, I mean, this company has been working with Nintendo for a while. And they haven't had their own character in Smash. And the Ninja Gaiden series did debut on Nintendo, and it was pretty big in the old Nintendo days. So, and also, we don't have a retro character in Smash in terms of DLC, and I think Ryu just fits for that. So I think Ryu is a very good possibility of being our E3 character reveal. Miles, you're up.
Let's see. For my first character, I'm just going to get this one out of the way because he's fresh in my mind. Dr. Eggman from the Sonic the Hedgehog series. So, let's all be honest here. Everyone jumped aboard the Eggman train because of Sephiroth. we got one of the biggest video game villains of all time. Why not get the other one? We can have a whole slew of some of the greatest video game villains ever. And it would make a lot of sense because Sonic has been in need of another character for a long time. And as I say in my video coming out June 1st, by the way, we almost got that with Shadow, but he was stuck being an assist trophy. And Eggman just seems to be the most natural choice. He has a lot of potential for moveset. When I was researching, I had a hard time trying to figure out what exactly to do with him because there's just so much. But I can imagine him being a better version of Bowser Jr., having gadgets and tricks and everything with all that. And really, it would be one of the best moments to just see Sonic finally get another character and get another villain, because we can never get enough of those.
So question. Do you think it'd be possible that Metal Sonic would be a part of the moveset of Dr. Eggman in any way?
You know what? That's in my video. So, yes.
Oh, okay.
My idea is that would be his gimmick where, over time, Metal Sonic would... there'd be an Eggman meter. And when it Right when it becomes its brightest, Metal Sonic would appear, and he'd basically be Eggman's personal Sonic.
Ah, I see. Alrighty then. Well, guys, Miles' video will actually be coming out the same day that this video is coming out, so that will be in the description if you want to see his all moveset ideas with Dr. Eggman. Tachi, you're up.
Yeah, so I also had, or have, Dr. Eggman as the first character. He is one of my most wanted characters. I've wanted him for a while. Before I talk a little bit about Eggman, I do want to talk about Ryu a bit. I don't think he is going to be in Smash. I can't put my finger as to like exactly why, but I just have a feeling I don't think it's gonna be him.
I personally don't think we're seeing another villain character, but I hope that happens. I'm a big Sonic supporter. I would love to see another Sonic character in Smash. I was really pushing for Shadow. My dream Sonic character would be Silver, but I know that's never gonna happen.
But, you know, I don't blame you for not thinking that there might not be another villain, because like, Sakurai made Sephiroth such a big deal.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
yeah, he
made
did.
It an emphasis that he was like the video game big boss. Yeah, so yeah. Like, Eggman would, like, at best, Eggman would kind of be like an encore to that.
Mm-hmm.
So like, I really don't blame you there. Mm-hmm. And you know what? To mention what you said about Ryu Hayabusa, I remember like there was a lot of discussion about him during like when the game. Before the game came out,
right.
Because like after the Bulmas came out, like we almost got all of the classic NES characters,
mm-hmm.
And like, you know, an NES library would not be complete without Ninja Gaiden. That game is too frustrating to forget. And with Koei Tecmo being so close to Nintendo, like it seems like he'd be a shoo-in.
Mm-hmm.
Like there's nothing really stopping Ryu Hayabusa. Just the fact that like he's not as requested as a character like Eggman. Or mm-hmm. like Banjo in the past or all that, but like it'd be a pleasant surprise looking into that. I just know that there will be people disappointed, but I do hope that he uses a scythe for his moveset if he ever actually gets linked in.
So I'm gonna do one character still, but for my next two characters I am 99% sure that these people are in. Just one of them's in, I just don't know who. So I'm going to start off with Crash Bandicoot. Crash Bandicoot makes very much sense to be in Smash Bros. With the whole fighting game history. Since, you know, Mario and Crash, back in the day, they had that whole history thing. I think you could make a really funny trailer out of this if Crash Bandicoot got in Smash. Mm-hmm. I feel like at E3, they want to make a loud noise, like literally break the internet. Breaking the internet would be Crash Bandicoot, I feel like. They seem to want to break the internet with these big shows. They did it with the Game Awards. They did it with E3 last time. I was going to say last year, but we didn't have an E3 last year. But the year before that, they had Banjo-Kazooie to like break the internet. I feel like Crash Bandicoot is that character to literally break the internet. People's going to be talking about that. And I think Crash Bandicoot moveset just makes perfect sense for Smash. You could do a lot of gimmicks. I know with the DLC characters, they like to have gimmicks. Hey, with Crash, you can do gimmicks.
Yeah.
And it would just be, to be honest with you, I feel like that would be a perfect character to end off third party for Smash, you know, because of the whole fighting game history with Crash and Mario and Sonic, all of that stuff. It'd be perfect. But there's another character, which I'll be talking about next time when I'm talking, that also makes perfectly good sense to be in Smash. But not both of them are going to be in Smash, though. That is my prediction. All right. Miles, you are up.
Well, you know what? My second character was also Crash Bandicoot.
Ooh.
Just due to the fact that, yeah, you are completely right that is an internet-breaking choice. He is one of the big. He was one of the biggest video game mascots of the 90s. Represented the PlayStation and all of that. And funny enough, that Smash is becoming a better PlayStation All Stars than PlayStation All Stars. So and like nothing would break the internet more than seeing Mario, Sonic, Mega Man, Pac-Man, Bandicoot just all next to each other. The big platformers and all that. And Banjo-Kazooie, of course.
Mm-hmm.
There is a lot of movement potential there. You know, I can imagine him being just real fun to play too. And you know what? I could even imagine him needing a costume of his sister Coco. Because yeah. I know a lot of people like playing the female alts compared to the male alts for whatever reason. But overall, like this would cement Crash Bandicoot's spot into just being in Smash Ultimate's video game Hall of Fame. Because that's kind of what Smash Ultimate has become.
Mm-hmm, I agree with that.
Yeah. So, yeah. No, like, that would just be one of the best surprises we could get during E3. Supposing there is another surprise, which I'm pretty sure we all have an idea of who that might be, but I'm going to save that for what y'all say.
Alrighty then. Itachi, you're up.
Yeah. So Crash isn't on my list, but I think that he has a good chance. The only thing that puts like any doubt in my mind is that we don't know the future of Crash at the moment because of what Activision is doing. And although that may not impact his chances in Smash, I do think that could impact at least a little bit, and it's just that's the only doubt in my mind, but even then it's a very small doubt. I think that he has a really good chance. Well, why not? He is a really, really good mascot. The show would be really funny with, especially with what they could do, but he's just not on my list because I have a few others that I think might have I don't know about better shot, but I think that I would just want more. Mm-hmm. And this one is, I don't know if anyone is going to include a first party character in their list, but I have a first party character that it could be. And I think that if it is a first party character, it is going to be someone from The Legend of Zelda. And I think it is going to be Impa from Age of Calamity specifically. I think that, for the trailer, what they could do is I thought this, a few days ago, Age of Calamity is the first DLC for that is probably going to get detailed at E3. I think that they could start off detailing it, and I think that the that it could be revolving around Pura, and then I think at the end of that, like whatever they detail, they could include a cute trailer with Pura and Impa, and that could segue into Impa getting into Smash.
Huh? You know, that's fair. Zelda's been needing a new fighter for forever. Yeah. Because I'm sure everyone's sick of three Links, two Zeldas, and the Ganondorf. So yeah. some variety is needed there. And you know what? Age of Calamity has a really cool moveset for Impa. So that'd be very welcome.
Yeah.
You know, me personally, I would like to see a fourth Link, but I guess I'll be okay with Impa being in Smash.
I mean, you know, it's funny because, like, I'm sitting here like, dang, but I made a video on if Classic Ganon got in Smash, so you freaking because we've needed a Magic Ganondorf for a while, but we're not gonna get that with regular Ganondorf. He's just gonna be Falcondor forever.
You know, Dark Link as an Echo Fighter? You know, that.
Oh, God.
I'm kind of surprised they didn't do that.
That's amazing. Alright, that leaves me with me now. Alrighty. So, I told you that I feel one of these is 100% in the fighter's pass. I just don't think it's going to be both of them. I feel like this is actually going to be the war. Because, you know, back in 2018, in the E3 days, the war was Banjo-Kazooie versus Steve. Because no one thought both of them would get in, at least in the same fighter's pass. I think this year's Smash Bros. War is actually going to be Crash Bandicoot versus Rayman. I feel like Rayman has equally the same amount of chances that I've said with Crash Bandicoot being in Smash Bros. There is so much going for Rayman out there. I've made a dedicated video on Rayman before, like a year ago. So I think Rayman is a very possibility. One of the things of, I'm just going to say why I think Rayman, is Mii costumes. There's a whole Ubisoft collaboration Mii costume pack out there in Smash Bros. Ultimate. They have Rabbids, which I know is a Rayman character. They have Assassin's Creed, and I think that's it. There's no Rayman. Then you could say arguably that Rayman is one of, if not the main mascot of Rayman, or Rayman of Ubisoft. It makes very no sense to me why they put rabbits as a Mii costume, but no Rayman Mii costume. I know people are going to be quickly to point out, well, how can you do a Rayman Mii costume? The arms, it just doesn't make sense. Well, what I have to say with that is, actually, with the rabbit's Mii costume, they released it as a hat only. And we saw with the Minecraft skins for the Mii costumes, like with the pig, they separated the whole body and they just made it work. It makes no sense to me that we don't have a Rayman Mii costume unless he's in Smash. And Ubisoft has been wanting a character in Smash for a very long time. They have been very much supporters of Smash Bros. They've been talking about trying to get Rayman in Smash since literally 2014 when they sent Sakurai a 3D model of Rayman, and you know, Sakurai thought that was funny that they sent them that. But anyways, I think Rayman just makes so much sense for so many reasons. You know, game history, it makes sense to have Rayman. Obviously, Rayman wouldn't break the internet as much as Crash Bandicoot, but Rayman would still break the internet. I'm not gonna deny that. It's just Crash would make a bigger outcry, I feel like. So, me personally, I think Crash or Rayman is going to be in the Fighter's Pass, and I'm 99% sure Ryu Hayabusa is going to be in the Fighter's Pass. And the only reason why I'm really pushing that idea, that narrative, that Ryu's going to be in Smash Bros. Is because Nate the Hate, very credible leaker, a lot of people don't know about him, but when he talks about Nintendo stuff, he is literally never wrong. He's been saying Ryu Hayabusa for the last, since Steve got revealed, actually, that he would be in the game. So that's my list. Miles, you're up.
So, the last character that I am, well, mostly confident in is Master Chief from the Halo series.
It's interesting.
Ooh, nice.
Now, originally I was just going to say a Pokemon from Sword and Shield, because we have no Gen 8 Pokemon to represent the new generation, and Smash loves being up to date with that. But for E3, we've never had a Pokemon choice, and let's be honest, a lot of people, the Pokemon are very disappointing.
Yes.
So, if they want to do another break the internet moment, then Master Chief is the perfect choice. And if you want to be technical, this wouldn't be Master Chief's first Nintendo appearance because, you know, Fortnite.
Yeah.
So, and with Microsoft and Nintendo being so nice and chilled with each other, I see no reason why Microsoft would have any problem putting their big guy, their big mascot, into Smash. And he has a lot of moveset potential. There's so many weapons in Halo they could work with. And they could even make a real cool trailer with him and Samus. Like, maybe they could do a sequel for the very first Smash Ultimate pre-render trailer with Ridley, where Master Chief goes to fight Ridley with Samus.
Yeah, I like that idea. I like that idea a lot, actually. Yeah, Itachi, you're up.
Yeah, so, this one might be, I'm gonna throw in a little bit, not more than, okay, so this will just be different for what I have. I am, what you said at the beginning of the video, Max, where you said that you don't think there's gonna be two characters, I am 50-50 on that. I think that there could be two characters, and I think that if they do two characters, then they have to break the internet. Mm-hmm. And I think that it could be either Sora or Master Chief. I did have Master Chief in there. I think it's one of those two. And I, unlike other people, I think a lot of people think that they're going to begin and end with Smash when they say two characters. I think it's possible that they could have both characters in the same cinematic. My idea, like very rough idea, was that Eggman, it could be made into a big deal, like Sephiroth was made into a big deal. Sonic is gonna try to stop him, but somehow Eggman figures out something to stop him, and then all of a sudden Sora gets summoned somehow and stops him and comes in. That's one idea. If they do Master Chief, like Miles said, they could do something with Metroid. I don't know who the first character would be, but I think that it is possible that they could reveal both the characters in the same one. But that is just who I wanted to say. Those two are that I wanted to say, like, as the final character. I think both would break the internet. I think Master Chief is just a huge deal, and I think Sora is probably the most requested character left. I know a lot of people say Geno, but I think that's a vocal minority. And you can make the same case. I think you can say the same case for Sora. But if but like Kingdom Hearts is just such a big IP everywhere that I think Sora would just be a big deal. And a lot of people make the argument that Sephiroth is already in, so Sora can't be in. But Sora technically belongs to Disney, so Nintendo would have to talk to Disney, which you could also go against that. You could say that Disney's not gonna let them use Sora, but I think they don't have to necessarily talk to Square Enix about it. They can go straight to Disney themselves, since Disney technically owns the rights to Kingdom Hearts.
So, on the Master Chief stuff, I think it's a cool idea. But I'm actually going to predict down the road in one of these fighter passes, when they show off the Mii costumes, they usually show like a big collaboration Mii costume. I feel like Master Chief's would end up as a Mii costume. Alrighty then. Well, that is all our predictions, guys. I'll let you guys plug each other, starting with Itachi, and then we'll wrap up this video. Alright, Itachi, you're up.
Yeah. You guys can go ahead and find me at twitch.tv/ItachiCosplays. I stream Monday through Saturday. Monday through Friday is at 8 p.m. Pacific. Saturday is usually 9 to 10, depends when I am available. I do playthroughs, I do podcasts, which Max will be in the next episode, actually, and I play games with viewers as well. So you guys should check me out.
All right, Miles, you're up.
You can find me at Miles Per Hour on YouTube. You can find me at twitch.tv/221mph. I mostly play a lot of Nintendo or Dragon Ball FighterZ games on my Switch. You can find, I usually stream on Tuesdays and Sundays. I'm going to change my times to probably sometime in the afternoon. And you can also find me on Twitter with miles_per_hour and the number one.
All right. Well, guys, thank you for coming on and being my guests. Very much appreciated having you guys on. Miles's video on Eggman is coming out the same day as mine, so check out the description. Should be out then, and yeah. Alrighty, guys. Well, that brings us to the end of the video. Make sure to like the video. Check out my Discord server. Follow me on Twitter, and make sure to / that subscribe button. All the links to everyone's videos will be in the description, their Twitches, all that stuff, and all of that good stuff. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.